Hello all. So in this class, we'll be discussing about the draft tube theory and its efficiency. And also I'll talk about specific speed of turbines. Now draft tube, as you've seen in both your coupling and Francis turbine, at the end of the turbine, you have your, after your runner, the casing is attached with a draft tube. Now, draft tube is present only for your reaction turbines where the energy at inlet is both kinetic as well as pressure. Now, what is a draft tube? It is basically a pipe of gradually increasing area. Okay, so your section one, if it is attached to your runner casing, the section two is at your tail race, below your tail race. And the condition is your area is increasing. Okay, and as I told you, it connects the outlet of runner to the tail race, and tail race, it is immersed inside my tail race. Your tail race is a level of water in the downstream of a dam, okay? And it converts the rejected kinetic energy to useful pressure energy. Now, since it's converting the kinetic energy to useful pressure energy, it is increasing the net head of the turbine. And since it's increasing the net head, it also increases its efficiency. Okay, now when I say converts rejected kinetic energy, so kinetic energy is very high. So when I introduce to your draft tube, the kinetic energy is getting converted to pressure, and that's why the water is able to pull up. So instead of non-utilizing the kinetic energy for the flow, I am converting into pressure and making it useful. Now without inserting a draft tube, what happens? The kinetic energy gets rejected and will go for a waste. Plus, you will have this issue because at the outlet of the runner, what is happening? Negative pressure is created. So the movement of water also becomes another issue. Now we have done two types of turbines, so I'll just see. So here, this is one type of draft tube, which is conical. It is a straight down. Okay, this is your Francis turbine. So the water goes around and then through the turbine, it comes down. The other example is of your coupling turbine. Your coupling turbine has a draft tube with circular section at inlet and rectangular at outlet. Now here also, my intention is my area is increasing. Section one and section two area is increasing, but it's two different shape. It is, circular at inlet and it has got a rectangular outlet, and both are below your tail race level. Now there are four types. You don't have to go in detail. You just have to know the four types. The simple one is a conical or divergent draft tube, which we have in our Francis turbine. The second one is your elbow tube cross section. So with a circular cross section at inlet and rectangular outlet, this is one we are using for your Kaplan turbine. The third one, which is not being used commonly, is your simple elbow draft turbine. Okay. Both are circular section, but the outlet area is more. And you have one more called as moody spreading draft tube. Okay, so it spreads out the water to both the direction. You have an inlet and outlet. Now these both are used in special cases depending on the site conditions. Okay, now next we go on to the theory behind my draft tube. So I'm taking the simple conical case. So I have a smaller area on top, a larger area at the bottom. It is immersed well inside the level of water downstream. So I'm taking a conical draft tube. So let HS be the vertical distance above tail race from section one, and Y be the distance of bottom of draft tube from the tail race. Now here we'll be applying a Bernoulli's equation. We'll be trying to find out what is the pressure at section A. So we'll be using the Bernoulli's equation at section one here and section two, that is your inlet, the inlet of your draft tube and outlet of draft tube. This is connected to your turbine casing and this is open, but it is way inside your water. Now I'm applying Bernoulli's equation, and whenever I apply Bernoulli's equation, I should have a reference. So I'm taking this section two as my reference to calculate my Z value. Okay, so taking this as reference, I'll be getting P1 by rho G plus V1 square by 2G. Your P1 is a pressure at section 1. V1 is a velocity at section 1 plus Z1. So here Z1, I know from the figure your Z1 is. So this is section 1. My datum is section 2. So this total height is my value. So that is nothing but HS plus Y. Now coming to section 2, P2 is at section 2 pressure at rho g, pressure at section 2 is P2. So P2 by rho g, velocity at 2, V2 square by 2g. Now since this is the datum itself, my Z value is 0. So I substituted 0. And since I'm considering losses, I've got frictional head loss. I'm considering the main loss is due to friction. There is no bend. It's only increasing area. So I'm writing frictional head loss. So here, where loss of energy between section 1 and 2. And if you come to know, if you see the figure, if you remember your open channel hydraulics, now this part is open to atmosphere. So this part is having atmospheric pressure plus this Y. So my pressure head is given by atmospheric pressure by rho g plus y. Okay, the pressure at any point is given by the depth of water. So at this point, the pressure is given by atmospheric pressure by rho g plus this vertical distance y. So I'll substitute that as P2, P2 by rho g. So I'm substituting this as P2 by rho g as atmospheric pressure by rho g plus y. Now, atmospheric pressure in Pascal is given by 1 into 10 to the power 5 Pascal. Your Pascal is nothing but Newton per meter square. I always remember your atmospheric pressure as 760 mm of mercury or 10.33 meters of water. And if I take the atmospheric pressure value, it is 1 into 10 to the power 5 Newton per meter square. So this plus y. So I'm substituting that in this equation which is given. So I'm writing P1 by rho g plus V1 square by 2g plus HS plus Y. So I'm substituting this value of P2, PA by rho g plus Y plus V2 square by 2g plus 0. Y0 because it's your datum. So your Z value is 0 plus HF. You can see I can cancel my Y and Y. And since I'm trying to find my P1 value, I'm taking all the other terms on the right hand side. So if I'm taking on the right hand side, I've got PA by rho g minus HS minus V1 square by 2g plus V2 square by 2g plus HF. Now these three terms, I'm taking the minus outside. Okay. So if I take the minus outside, my terms inside will be V1 square by 2g minus V2 square by 2g minus HF. Remember that V1 is greater than V2. If you say the figure, your V1 is greater than V2 just because the area of cross-section is less. Okay. Your discharge is the same. Your area of cross-section is less. So your V1 is having higher velocity to your V2. So this term will be a positive term minus your this. Now if you notice that from your atmospheric pressure head, you are subtracting HS. And you're subtracting this term. So we know that definitely your P1 by rho g will be less than your atmospheric pressure head. So it is important that whatever, you know, pressure is, since pressure is less, your velocity is high, and that velocity, high velocity, has to be converted back to your pressure. One thing, I increase my net head and I can move the water out of my turbine runner. So it becomes mandatory to have a draft tube. So this equation tells you that the pressure at section 1 is less than my atmospheric pressure. So that is vacuum pressure. So I require a system wherein I am able to pull out the water from here. And how I'm doing it, I'm providing an increasing area. Here the velocity is high. I'm converting the velocity into your pressure and pulling out the water. And also by pulling out the water, I'm increasing the net head of the turbine. And since net head is increasing, I'm increasing the efficiency also. So this is the working of the turbine. So since we're speaking about efficiency, we'll calculate the efficiency of the draft tube also. The efficiency of the draft tube is calculated by actual conversion of kinetic head into pressure head divided by kinetic head at inlet of draft tube. So V1 is the velocity of water at inlet of draft tube, V2 velocity of water at outlet of draft tube, and HS. Now theoretically, the conversion of kinetic energy to pressure head will be given by V1 square by 2G minus V2 square by 2G. That is a theoretical. Now when I consider the actual one, I have to consider my head loss due to, you know, due to head loss due to friction or losses due to your friction. So my actual conversion of kinetic head to pressure head will be V1 square by 2G minus V2 square by 2G minus HF. And when I substitute in my efficiency of draft tube, I have got my actual conversion divided by kinetic head at the inlet of draft tube, that is by V1 square by 2G. So this is my efficiency. This has been asked once in your paper. In 2018 paper, the entire thing, what define a draft tube, tell me the types, and draft tube theory and efficiency as one 10 marks question. Now the next part I'm going to say take is a specific speed. In the beginning, when we had started the turbines, I had mentioned based on your on the classification, this was the last classification, low specific speed, medium specific speed, and high specific speed. Now, before I go through all this theory, okay, I'll just tell you a practical aspect. Now, whenever we do turbine studies, we do studies on a model. Your model is basically a very small version of the actual turbine, and we pass water through it, calculate the power, calculate the speed, calculate the head, and do a number of studies in that. Now, if I have a practical case, okay, just imagine a practical case. I have a river. I want to have a hydroelectric power plant. I know the discharge of the river and what is the depth of the river. So I know what is ahead. Now, if I'm having a power project in mind, I'll have, okay, I need to serve these many people. I will have an intent of, you know, having certain amount of power should be developed in if I have an hydroelectric power. So I know the power also. Plus, the speed of the turbine, the speed of the runner. So I want, okay, the speed to be in this range. So if I know all these three, I calculate my specific speed. And based on the value of specific speed, if it is following in this range, I'll be choosing my turbine accordingly. Okay, so when I have a practically hydroelectric plant, I know the discharge of water, the head of water. Usually there are agencies which measure it very regularly. So I know the head. I know what is my intention. See, when I have a hydroelectric power plant, I have a, you know, intention of serving so many people. So I have an intention. So I know what is the power requirement. So I know the power. Plus, I'm having a range of speed. Okay, this is the speed of the runner I want. So knowing these three, I'll be calculating my specific speed. The formula is given by, specific speed formula is given by N root of P divided by H to the power 5 by 4. Where N is the speed of the turbine, your power is the shaft power which we intend to produce, and H is the net head of turbine. This is a dimensioned specific speed, okay? There's a dimensional specific speed also, which is not there in your syllabus. This also I didn't see in your syllabus, but I thought it's a very useful information. This is a dimensioned specific speed. Now, remember that you may think that, okay, knowing this, it's so very simple. No. To calculate this N, P, and H requires a lot of meticulous studies. See, if I take the example of head, I need to know the data for a very long time. How much is the discharge? What is the maximum discharge? Minimum discharge? What is the depth? So all these parameters take a number of studies. And finally, you're using this formula. And before you actually intend to use what type of turbine, you have a lot of model studies for each turbine. Okay, model studies where we see, okay, the specific speed. Even for specific speed, do we do model study? What is the efficiency? Now, these two, all these values are based on where I'm getting my maximum efficiency. Finally, my intent is to get the maximum efficiency. So in this range, when we did model studies, we found that this range, the efficiency is maximum for Pelton wheel with single jet. In this range, your Pelton wheel with 2 days, the efficiency is maximum. Similarly, studies are done on model and then it is tried to implement it. They are trying to implement in your actual feed. So this is your background for your specific speed. This is my formula. Now I'll read out the definition. It is defined as a speed of a turbine which is identical in shape, geometrical dimension, blade angles, gate openings, etc., with the actual turbine, but of such a size that it will develop unit power when working under unit head. Okay, so you may be feeling that there's a whole new disconnect. Now, specific speed very clearly defines you that under unit head, what is the power unit? Under unit head, I won't have unit power. What is the speed required? Okay, so technically a theoretical definition is if my input is a unit head, 1 meter of head, and I want 1 kilowatt power, what should be the speed of your turbine? But practically, this is how we do it. We have to know the value of your speed, P and H. Based on that, I'll be calculating my NS, and I'll be seeing in this curve where it is coming. I'll be choosing my turbine accordingly. Remember, there are a lot of studies. This is just a simple way of telling it that, okay, knowing these three values, knowing each of the value has a lot of studies to be done. And this range also, this I've taken from your Bansal book. So these also are done all your models in lab and then concluded. So that comes to your end of your specific speed. Thank you.